Oh, what's going on? My name is Deshaun Lyons, one half of On the Dotted Line. And today's episode I'm going to talk about is mental health. Mental health is the number one problem in this country. I don't care what the stats say. I don't care what the data say. Mental health is the number one problem in this country. Because everybody has problems. I don't care if they feel like they have it all together. Everybody has problems. Everybody have things that's going on in their personal life. Everybody have things that goes on financially, relationships. And then the things that we see on social media is not even cool. So all them things that are exposed to us, that we see and that we deal with, it causes stress, and stress leads into depression. And then once we start being depressed, our mind starts to wander, and then we start to have all these dark thoughts in our head. And that's why we have so much hate in this country. We have so much division in this company, in this country. We have school shootings. We have bullying. We have all these things. And pretty much like we have different platforms on social media that promotes violence and negativity. They don't promote enough positive things, because social media could be like, it's a lot of benefits from social media. It's a lot of positive things that you could digest and you could learn from. But they promote the negative things. They promote the negative things. And look at the celebrities. The celebrities, they have to deal with it even more than what we have to deal with. Because of, they're going to have to deal with their own personal life. They got to deal with their families trying to like, you know, oh, you acting brand new. Then they got to deal with the public. The public, you might be getting, you're going to have mad trolls. People going to be saying, I hate you. I wish you died. Imagine dealing with 10,000 tweets saying, I hate you. What you think that does to you emotionally, psychologically? You can't just block that out. But you could like, okay, I'm going to cut off. I don't want to see that. So I'm going to take the comments off. You can do that. But then you want to seek that love too, because you in the public eye, your privacy is pretty much gone. So you want to get some love. So you like to see the positive things also. So the celebrities, they go through a lot. And then pressure on that they deal with on their job, they go through a lot too. So we can't just say they got all this money. Why we even care? They're still a human being. They still go through things too. And they probably go through it worse than an average person, because they have a lot of people count on them. They try to make sure they try to make sure their fans is good. They try to make sure they keep performing at a high level for their fans. And they trying to have a little bit of their privacy, a little bit of it. So I feel like they have to always see a therapist. They have to always see a therapist. Charlamagne said he see a therapist once a week, and that's good. And I feel like everybody should see a therapist. I don't care if you feel like you have it all together, because you don't. You don't. You don't, because it's always going to be something. It's always going to be something that you're exposed to that is not normal. It's not normal. Like the things that we see on social media. Like, every time I'm on Facebook or Instagram, I'm always seeing a fight. Whether it's Bad Girls Club, whether it's Love and Hip Hop, all these reality shows, or you'll see just somebody recording a fight. What you think that does to us when we keep seeing those things? It's like, it's normal. And people would take it and they would laugh about it. That's not cool. That's not cool. Because our interaction is going to be based off of the things that we see on social media. So that is not cool at all. That is not good at all. And then they have people dying on social media. Look at X. Look at the situation with X. When X was shot in his car, he was already done on the spot. And he was just laying there in his car. Instead of calling 911, somebody's recording it on their phone. Look how we react right now. That's not cool. Back in the day, it's like, call 911. We could save that brother's life. Even if he was alive or not. Still call 911 before you take the phone out. Taking the phone out and recording. Now people, and also people's doing certain things for clout. Certain things that is not normal. If you're eating detergent pods to get 100,000 likes and 100,000 followers, you need to see somebody right away. You need to see somebody right away. Right away. That's not cool. Social media enhances. Because like I said, it's some good things about it, but they love to promote the negative things. That's why people would do all these stunts, because they know they're going to get a reaction. The reaction creates opportunities and resources. And that's terrible. Because people's losing lives, people's getting sick, and people's unhappy. And when you're unhappy and you depressed, you have these dark thoughts in your head. You start thinking about suicide. And the suicide rate is an all-time high right now because of mental health, because of social media. People cyberbullying and all of that. Then also, we could talk about the community, our community, especially me growing up in the hood. The black community, we deal with more trauma probably than any other race, because the things that we're exposed to, that is not cool. We have to deal with our community, the hate, the self-hate in our community. We have to deal with seeing gun violence, seeing murder, seeing drugs. And then we have to deal with racism, that if you go to a certain community, they might treat you differently. And then you might grow up with hate in your heart, saying that, you know, they did this to me when I was a kid, and I hate them ever since. That's why it's very important, and I feel like the solution to all of this is mandatory counseling from kindergarten all the way up to 12th grade when you're about to graduate high school. I feel like it's very important for us to be able to talk to a therapist, that we must talk to a therapist, because growing up is tough, man. It's as a kid, you know, and I mean, well, it's tough as a kid, but it's nowhere compared to when you finally graduate and when you in the real world and when you are an adult, you have responsibilities and all these things. Because if you're going to have kids, you don't want to bring all those baggages to your kid. You don't want to give it to your kid, or you don't want to put your kid in an environment that you don't have it all together because you didn't get help, and then your kid have to suffer from the things that you go through. So it's very important. It's very important. That's why a lot of relationships are damaged. And then they bring, so one person that's damaged interact with another person that's damaged, create a toxic relationship. And then they so complacent. It's like you both sitting in a pit of freaking mud. You just sit in a pit of mud, just chilling in there. It's a toxic environment. That's why I feel like mental health is, we have to really focus on this. I feel like that's the number one problem in this country. If we focus on that, everything will be solved. Everything, all the problems that we're dealing with in this country, whether it's, you know, even politics, religion, you know, all these different feminism groups, all these problems that we suffer from. If we get help and we focus on getting help, everything will be solved. Everything will be solved from there. I'm not saying society is perfect, but it will be a hell of a start. It will be a hell of a start. So I just wanted to do this episode to talk about that, because, you know, I was dealing with some personal things that's going on, because the things I have to deal with, like just being an adult in America is tough. It's tough, you know, dealing with that. And I see everybody else going through it, like everybody, you know, going through deaths. Like one of my closest friends' brother, you know, he passed away, and it kind of messed me up. It was just because it's like in your own neighborhood, like people just reacting off of impulse, and they just like boom, and they just, that's it. You don't care about nobody's life. because you don't care about your own. And that's, and especially in the hood. Like, I don't know if I talked about Nipsey. This video is about like 10 minutes long so far. I don't know if I briefed up on Nipsey, but I'm gonna say it again if I said it before. If you shot, like, Nipsey was doing so much for his community that somebody shot and killed him. And the things that he was doing to his community, he gave 4,000 people in his community jobs. And somebody in his hood shot and killed them. That's where you know mental health is the number one problem in this country. For somebody to have that much hate for this brother, and this brother is doing the most for his community. He don't have to come back. He don't have to come back, and he don't have to help his community for nothing. He helping his community because he wants to help his community. He wants to empower his community. He wants to empower his people. He's all about solutions. But somebody shot and killed him. This is the problem. This is a problem that we need to focus on mental health. We need to focus on it. So if anybody's going through something, or if anybody is just need to talk to somebody, man, see a therapist, look it up, go on Google, look up the closest center possible, whether you have addictions, whether you just feel like you're in a dark place, just look for the closest center possible, and just go to a therapist. Go to a therapist and talk about your problems and release all the frustrations. I'm telling you, once you're able to do that, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it because I feel like I don't have it all together. And I feel like for me and where I'm trying to head, and for me to help others, I got to make sure I'm good. Because you can't help somebody if you don't have it all together. So I would say, everybody, I'm telling y'all, please, if you don't got it all together, or even if you do, still see somebody, go to Google and check out the closest therapist that you can go and talk to, and get that help, man. Mental health is the number one problem in this country, and I feel like that's very important, man. But we're going to take a quick commercial break. After that, I'm going to give the shout out. So this is On the Dotted Line. Be back in 2.2. Brain to make it home like I'm used to. Brain to make it home like I used to. Brain to make it home like I'm used to. Top down on the down like I'm used to. Brain to make it home like I used to. Brain to make it home like I used to. Welcome back. This is On the Dotted Line. This is your boy Deshaun Lyons. You already know, one half of On the Dotted Line. Quick shout out to my boy DA Realist Podcast. Go check out his podcast on all the platforms: Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, all those platforms. You want to check him out. Also, please, everybody right now, follow us on our IG, On the Dotted Line 18. Please follow us. We want to thank all the people that have been supporting our movement. It's been 1 year, and we kicking up. And tomorrow, we'll be at Atlantic City doing the show. So stay tuned for that. Well, it's today, because today is tomorrow. But yeah, we'll be at Atlantic City. We'll be doing an episode, me and Marquise. You already know, we're gonna have a really good one. And our online store, DM Line. Everybody right now, DM Line 18 on IG. Everybody go to DM Line 18 on IG and follow and check out all our gym apparel. We have dope gym apparel, dope products. I'm telling y'all, it is lit. Please check it out. And everything is 25% off. You're not going to find any other store that have cheaper products that is great material, durable. You're not going to find any other gym apparel stores that's like that. Quick shipping. Check us out. DMLine 18. Go at, you know, follow us on IG, DMLine 18, and check out all our gym apparel over on there. And I'm gonna put the link for our for the store. So I'm gonna put the link on the description box. And also, please subscribe. Please subscribe to us on the Dotted Line episodes. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and share and like. This is a very important video about mental health. So please, please share, like, and subscribe. But yeah, man, my name is Deshaun Lyons, one half of On the Dotted Line. Peace.